Anyway.
I watched the Taylor Swift documentary. It's great. If you, even if you don't like Taylor Swift, you know it's listed under political documentaries because they talk about a big part of it is her decision to
become political.
Become political.
Right.
And that's an important part of that because of what she did.
Now,
with
is her
voice.
Music in it?
Yes. What? Yes, but not. I thought there, as a Taylor Swift fan, I wanted more music. It shows her writing the songs, which to me, that's a fascinating process. They just had a camera on. So when she's just like in her head, she's a beast. She's just like coming up with beats in her head and how this song will go. She's doing it. She's telling the producer and he's coming in with.
Or someone has given her the beat and they're filming it like it's hers, which could be her.
Yeah.
I know her a little bit about her, the way she operates.
Yeah. Again,
you don't not everything you see is what's going on.
But not everything you hear is what's going on.
But I have experience with her being crazy.
But and I'm sure she's had crazy moments.
For sure.
But
just know that could be happening.
That could be happening. And I'm saying I don't believe it because this girl's been writing songs since she was 12 years old.
Or she's definitely been having somebody write songs for her since she was 12.
Disagree.
Okay.
Do you have direct knowledge that someone writes her songs? Then
I do not.
Say that.
No, I do not.
So then, for some reason, that's rubbed me the wrong way because she writes all those songs.
Okay. She writes it all. She writes all those bangers.
She does.
Those classic the fucking.
Why do you think she
does
it?
The songs that Natty could write right now.
Disagree.
I told her.
So you'd think Taylor Swift's not a good songwriter?
I think.
She's massive.
I think Taylor. That I know.
How many Grammys does she have?
Hold on. None of that means anything.
Uh-huh.
Whether she's a talented songwriter or not.
So you ask your people that.
Bob Dylan is a talented songwriter.
That's music you like. Because you don't like Taylor Swift music, I'd argue that Taylor Swift.
She writes a version of music that is insanely, insanely
commercial.
Okay,
but so were the
commercial.
Beatles. So were the Beatles. You're saying easy? The Beatles were the most commercial band ever.
Well, no, they didn't write songs for commercial.
And I'm saying that's just her songwriting. Like, why do you think she just does it to make money?
Great. I'm not going to argue with
you. I'm not going to argue with you. You must have certain knowledge of her acting crazy because she, and I think you've told me the story. I don't understand why you hate her so much.
I don't hate her.
I don't understand why you don't give her credit of being a good songwriter.
Because she's a pop girl. She writes, those songs are terrible to me.
To you.
Yeah, they're like insanely commercially shitty pop song. Here, have this.
She goes to, if you're going to play Blank Space, I'm pretty sure you're going to play Blank Space. Right?
I'm going to play that because you just told me to.
So she kind of does the Beyonce version of it. The songwriters credited on that are Max Martin, Johann Schuster, and Taylor Allison Swift at the end of it.
Okay, so, but I will guarantee you that she's writing all the lyrics. How about that?
No chance, because the last credited songwriter is the one who contributed the least to the song. So this is a very simple beat and a very simple lyrics. There's not much else to contribute if you're at the end of the line. She probably just gave context of her personal life.
I really think you guys are lowering what she does, and I don't appreciate it. But you can say whatever you want.
First of all, I know you don't. You really love her.
I do. I
back her. I respect your love
for all the people that you talk to use a voice about politics, and if you watch this documentary, her dad's there being like, you can't do this. This is going to kill half your fans. Like, she's Miss Country.
No, and you can respect the shit out of her as a person. I think that you might like her as a person.
And I like her song, so I enjoy a couple of her albums. A couple albums I didn't connect to. I thought those were bad songs. But there were a couple albums that she's a great songwriter, and if you're just going to say that music shit, she's not a great songwriter, I just don't like that argument.
It'd be great, though, if she was kind of a great person and wasn't really the writer of these shitty songs. She hired people to write her shit songs.
These shitty songs, she writes her life. You can tell if you listen to Taylor Swift music. I know you've only heard a couple songs.
Will you get me the lyrics to Blank Spaces?
I have them, but Chris, she wrote her first album.
Okay.
She wrote the songs. She was lead vocals background. And she had some producers, but the lyrics were hers.
Okay.
On these newer pop albums, she has songwriting teams. Max Martin is a pretty renowned songwriter. I know he's done work for Beyonce. So she's transitioned because you can only write so much shit.
I love that Vanger backs her. That's what I really, enjoy about this when we talk about her. Right. He's into her. He backs her. He's like, fuck it. I'm in on her.
You guys lower what she does. She's a beast. And if she was in here right now, and performed a song. Like, I can't wait to go to one of her concerts. I don't understand why there's so much hate.
Are you a Swiftie?
I'm definitely a Swiftie.
I'm
definitely a Swiftie. I don't understand. I just, it bothers me. All
she's a songwriter. She's a songwriter. She's a legitimate songwriter. But I think Shane's got a point too about now she writes shit pop songs.
I mean, I think her most recent record is probably my favorite record that she's done. So
this is also a pop song.
I'm not listening. Oh, I know what this is.
This is a pop song. Now let's just talk about the structure. Take you down. This is a pretty complex attempt at writing a song, is it not?
Yeah. This is a great song.
This is a pop song to me.
Okay.
Whatever Taylor is making is something that's manufactured
it's
by
different.
A bunch of different people in order to make money. These guys weren't writing this to make money. They were writing this to write songs.
They actually, I watched the Beatles documentary. They had a huge pressure to put out a certain amount of songs by the guy they call the fifth Beatle. Like, I'm going to research his name right now, but George Martin was their producer. But Paul and John worked effortlessly together, so it wasn't a big deal. So they were just fucking talented and they did it. But they did have commercial pressure to capitalize on Beatlemania in America once they hit.
Got it.
Yeah. They're commercial.
There's a little bit of a difference between this song and that Blank Spaces. Would you agree?
Yes. Again, though, it's what you like. You don't like that type of music that she's writing, and you think it's lower on the scale of like good music, which I don't understand. Music's all subjective. I could think this song's shit. I could sing there's no melody in this song.
Yeah.
I could think I don't like this guy's voice. This is shit. Yeah. Right? So that's my opinion, and you feel that way about Taylor Swift in like a hatred sort of way about her music.
I don't.
She came in. This is Britney Spears.
I love this. This is fucking great. Baby, can't you see? This is fucking terrible. And I love it.
Okay.
Pretty cool.
But it's terrible.
Right. She didn't write any of this.
You could write this.
Did Britney Spears write any of this song?
Don't care.
Well, see, that's where Taylor Swift differs.
No, but he's just saying that they're like 13 of the biggest songwriters on Earth.
And I'm saying that if you had her in here, I'm going to believe that if you're like, hey, when you wrote this song, what was the process? Did you have a lot to say? And she'd be like, yeah, I came up with a lot of this beat and a lot of the song structure.
We're going to be done with it right up to the top. Yeah, this is the chorus. Now, Natty.
Yeah.
They're both in the same vein of hyper commercial pop.
Yeah.
That's much better than that other shit, right?
I think that's more innovative at the time. And like commercially innovative. It was a new sound. Taylor Swift just rips off hip hop trap beats. That's all. That's all she does.
You guys just have hate. It's not even worth arguing. It's like you're part of the hate cult of Taylor Swift.
That's not true.
It is true.
I like her early stuff when she would play acoustic guitar. Like
that's country. That's her country. She's gone from a country artist to a pop artist, and I enjoy her pop music. Yeah. And there's just hate that music is terrible. No one's listened to any of her new record except for maybe the singles.
Hold on a second. There's this one song I love of hers.
Love Story, the Romeo and Juliet song?
No, there's a song I love that's off the... Hold on a second. He's so mad that I don't like Taylor Swift.
Well, it's so mad that you just don't think that she wrote the shit. Like, that she just is a puppet, and I'm telling you, she's a beast. Like, she's unbelievable. And it sucks that no one appreciates that.
I think she's the biggest artist in the world.
Yeah.
I think plenty of people appreciate her.
Right, and I don't understand why there's so much hate towards her.
I think a lot of people appreciate her.
I like a good amount of the songs that she's written.
But well, the whole album she wrote of this most recent one, so maybe you should go take a listen to that one.
I'll listen to it.
Okay, because every single song is written by her and one other dude.
Okay.
So when you start referencing albums 6 years ago, 8 years ago, about different songs, this record is just her and one other dude.
I thought Blank Space was newer.
I played this a lot. I loved this one. You ready?
Oh, it's a great song.
Great. This shit's great.
Why don't you see who wrote this song? Why don't you get the writers on this song?
This song is terrible. Probably didn't. And I love it. But it's fucking terrible. You could write this.
I could not. I go on too
many dates. This song is terrible, and I love it. At least that's what people say. That's what people say. But I keep cruising. I fucking love this song, man.
You have the writers?
It's not even listed.
Fine.
Yep. She was wrote it with she's the first credited songwriter.
Oh, crazy.
On this one.
I love this song.
And it's the same guys who helped her write Blank Space.
Well, they obviously worked on this record together.
Max Martin and the
This was a big record
Johan
for her.
Guy.
This was a massive record. 1989.
This song's so terrible and fucking great. Anyway, let's get back to the doc.
Yep.
The Scooter Braun guy owns all her music.
But he's not in the doc at all. They don't talk about that.
Of course. But is her music in the doc? Because I think she had to buy the This is the shitty part. I think she had to buy the rights to her own music from Scooter in order to have it in the doc.
I don't think that there's not a lot of her. There's not one full song. How about that? There's not one full song.
And that's because they had to pay. And there's different prices.
Yeah.
For... Like, you want 12 seconds?
Yeah.
It's 400 grand.
And a lot
of it's... You want a minute and a half? It's a million two.
A lot of it's live performance that you hear maybe snippets and then, there's not that much of her music.
Whatever's going on between Scooter and her is rough. Whatever's going on is rough.
Yeah.
Scooter's got an axe to grind. It might be because of Ariana. Who knows, right?
Mm-hmm.
But he's sticking it to her. And she's an idiot who fucking let that go. I mean... Whoever was dealing with that, the mom or the dad, I mean, she owned that shit and then didn't figure something out legally with the guys that her, I mean, I, it's a massive fail on her part. And it's also Scooter and that, whoever owns that company, sticking it to her. I mean, it's a shitty situation. That whole thing is just shitty.
Because
that woman should be able to play whatever the fuck she wants for free.
Yeah.
And Scooter should be like, he should sell it back to her.
Yeah, they go into one aspect. Remember when she was sued by that DJ because he got fired?
Grabbing her ass or something?
Yeah,
right.
They go into that. That's rough. She countersued for $1 and won. And it just shows having to go through that. And just, I back her. Go watch the documentary if you hate her.
And he grabbed her ass?
Oh, my gosh. The photo is literally... The worst thing I'd never want to see that photo again.
He's full scrunch.
He might be scrunch and finger up.
Finger in DMZ.
Like, it seems vile. If someone did that to me with my pants on and she's wearing a skirt for these photos and he comes up and puts his hand right on her butt in
the
photo.
That creep should go to jail.
And then sued her.
That's sexual assault.
Because he was fired.
Yeah, that's sexual assault.